guys, so we're just going to go over a really basic sort of snatch tutorial today. So we're going to try and make things as simple as possible and as easy as possible to get you started. So the first thing you need to do whenever you're going to be doing snatches or cleans is you need to find your grip. With the snatch, you're going to need to make sure the bar is across the crease of the hip. So where I've got the bar at the moment, it's sort of just above where my thighs sort of end and just where my hips start. You don't want it too high, because then you're going to hit yourself on the stomach. You don't want it too low, because for blokes that's going to produce a problem when the bar contacts the thigh. So easiest way to find it, stand up tall with straight wrists, bar in the full hand, march up and down. If the bar moves a little bit or not at all, you've got the right spot. For some of you who are longer limbed, you're going to have to go collar to collar, and that still might not be wide enough, but there's ways we can sort of get around that later. From here, just want you to flip the bar up overhead, and we're going to go through the overhead position. So here, what we're looking for is wrists slightly back, like you're doing a push-up, shoulder blades pulled together, and really just trying to push the elbows together. So I'm trying to turn my armpits and my elbows up towards the sky. So that's our lockout position. All we want to check from there is if you can do an overhead squat. It doesn't matter if you can do it halfway down, a quarter way down, or all the way down, we just want to see how low you can get. So this is where we're trying to get. This is your finish position. So from there, we're going to go in front. First thing we're going to do is what's called a snatch right. So I want you to lock your legs out as hard as you can, squeeze your glutes, and drive the bar up to your chin. To here. Okay, from there we're going to add the legs. So you're going to dip to the knees and squeeze. Again, try to keep the bar over the middle of the foot. If you can do that, then all you're going to do is drive the bar to the chin and then go into an overhead squat. So jump and punch. So that's a snatch from the hip. What we will then do is try and go to the knee and get the bar to the chin by dragging the bar up the thigh. So the bar always comes off the hip. If you can do that, you're going to row it to the chin and then snap under it. If you can do that, you can then go down to the shin. Try and get it from shin to chin. If you can do that, let's go from shin to overhead. In its simplest form, what the snatch should look like is going from a sitting position to a standing position to a sitting position to a standing position. And you can use whatever words you'd like. You can say jump, sit, stand. You can say jump, squat, and stand. Whatever you want to do, but those are the basic positions you need to look through. So you need to make sure, as you're coming up, whether it's from the hip, from the thigh, from the knee, wherever, you'll get the bar high and tight, as high as you can. When you go into the snatch, you want to snap through into the overhead position. And from there, you sink. And if you slowly start to make those pieces a little bit less sort of segmented, grab a full snatch.